this show for a couple hours here, and then we'll call it there. Go to the show. Where were we in the schedule? Up against New York, we are... what? 41-39. I think getting my slider control up is probably better. Alright, we're coming in the 8th. I think by the end of this season we might be able to get back in the starting rotation. Keyword is maybe.
Number 11 takes the mound as he's been called upon to pitch.
Number 11.
I'm pitching with so many left-handers. It's a Cubs franchise. I think I have 3 rotation between Crow, Lester, and Quintana. So it's 3 lefties, and then I have 2 righties in Hendricks and Arrieta. My lefties have actually been pretty good, at least with Crow and Lester.
Here's Mookie Betts. So far, 2-for-3
looking
in this
for the bat.
Right pitch of the at bat on its way. High in the air down the right field line.
Hit hard, but he's out there.
Sousa back, and he reaches up to put it away for a long out number one. Digging in, Justin Bour. No thump at him in this game so far, as might be expected. He's 0-for-3. Bounce it to the left side, and that gets through for a one-out base hit.
It's a hard-hit ground ball.
Turn and heads for second. And he is in the second base with one away as the go-ahead run. Stepping up to the plate, Brandon Nimmo.
Oh, I'm coming into a game as tied, that's why.
Here it is. Knee-high slider that he takes a look at. Change-up gets him out in front for strike two. Ready on 0-2.
Got him.
Strike 3 called as he couldn't hold
it. There's Nimmo.
That was a big strike, guys. The best pitchers have.
Oh, sorry, guys. I've been sneezing a lot today.
They really need to. And that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
That's a ball.
Off the plate and low here, ball one. Go ahead, runs in scoring position here with 2 down. Swing and a line drive. Foul.
If I'm on the mound right now, I know I'm in the hitter's head. He was definitely sitting soft. I might speed him up and elevate it right here.
One ball and 2 strikes to count. The 2-2. Grounder down the line at third. This is a foul ball as the count holds steady as 1-2.
Come on, big guy, get the kick right here. Hey, catch up right here.
Curveball, or maybe even the circle change there. 2-2, regardless.
Hold up.
Story scoops it up.
All right.
He's out of there.
This will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. So no runs on it. Now, beautiful look there. And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Ahmed Rosario. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out. Hit down the line.
Here we go, right now, Cole. 1-1.
In for a strike, and he jumps ahead. 1-2 now. The 1-2. Very weakly on the ground. That winds up foul. The 1-2. Misses.
I get him to chase that.
That's a ball.
Line drive to left. Oh, and this kicks right off of him.
I don't know what that was, but okay.
Nobody out.
Well, unfortunately, being close isn't quite good enough.
Good, easy catching the ball, but all right.
And he was close to making that play, but instead it's a double. That's a risky play, though. Could have been a lot worse than a double.
One ball, no strike.
Brennan is the batter now as he looks at a ball, 1-0. This winds up inside for a ball.
Two balls, no strikes.
Possible winning run on second. No one out.
That's a ball.
The fastball low, and it's 3-0 now.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite.
3-1. And he fouls this one off. Now the 3-2 pitch. Popped him up.
Okay, got him the pop out there. That's good.
He's got it one away. Wilmer Flores.
Pinch hitter, this can be Wilmer Flores.
Wilmer Flores.
He's no joke either.
Strike one. In his career, Flores hitting under 300, but not by a lot. And as pitchers go, that's really an impressive.
Yep, that's why he's no joke.
Let's see if they send him around to try to score.
That's game.
Damn.
He lost there, Phil.
And guys, a very Damn. Important outing turned in on the mound for the man you see right there. He was a big factor, of course, and is the recipient of our top player of the game. Number 11 is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
Number 11.
Thank you.
I thought I was waiting for the batter to come up.
Ready now, Mookie Betts. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point.
Right fielder.
He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Getting some work in. Looks like.
And that's right there, and we're even at one. Ball and two strikes. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
This kind of hitter right here, we call this guy a grinder. What are grinders? They just kind of
got him.
Good pitches. They lay off the pitches just off the plate. This is every pitcher's nightmare. A guy that's up
there. Let's go, maybe.
Not just up there swinging at anything they can throw towards home plate.
Now batting. First baseman.
Into the box. Sean Gomez. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Hey, we shoot me. Come on, man.
I'm seeing him just a little too amped up. Out
there we go.
That's common with hard throwers like him. Running a blazing fastball up there is great, but if you can't harness it, what good does it do you?
Bounce it to the left side. Camargo's got it. Throw on to first, and the Mets are down to their final out. At the plate, Wilmer Flores. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Wilmer Flores.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Toward the line and right.
Okay.
Put this one away, and the Braves have taken game one of the series on the road as the ball game is over.
Well, this game had its moments, but it got out of hand pretty quick. Always nice when you can coast to a six-run win. Save your closer for another day.
Number 11 will take the ball now as the new pitcher.
Number 11.
I'm so used to pitching with these pitchers in the 90s, man. Sip Hendricks is like a high 80.
Now, Ahmed Rosario. He'll lead off the bottom of the ninth inning.
Second baseman, Ahmed Rosario.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Fastball swung on and grounded out towards second. Albies brings it in.
And you get out.
That's the first down. Next for the Mets, Tomas Nido.
Oh, it's a tie ball game. That's right, I'm not actually closing. I'm a relief pitcher, that's right. Forgot about that.
That's a ball.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with a bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty. But, hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
Ran it in on him. This is bounced toward short. In time to first, and there are two away. Luis Guillorme will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 15.
Fastball in there for the ball strike.
Oh, one.
Start this one at 269. Four home runs and 17 RBI. And line drive. That's going to be trouble. He's around first, heading for two. And this will get to the wall now, out beyond the 385 sign. And the possible winning run is into second base. He's got a two-out double.
the lineup flips over and digging in, Kevin Pillar. He's got a chance to bring
okay, I got the out.
Question is whether they'll even pitch to him. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Comes on to start the home inning.
Well, they had to put in a couple of we held for the one inning we had to.
A win is a win, and any win is good, especially on the road.
A one-run finish.
All right, now let's go over and...
A pitcher is issued a challenge by his coach.
Cool, just make me a starter, bro. Oh, we're in 82.
Number
11.
We just gotta pitch like we know how.
Baseman now, Mitch Moreland, 0-2 for
leading
him.
Leading off for the Red Sox. First baseman.
Nope. 8-9-1 to start the inning.
Moreland.
Pitch misses for ball one.
Hey, you can do it. No one better. Let's go.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
Whoa,
fastball
that
down below the knee.
Yeah, we got no one here.
Find some green, baby. Find some green.
Round ball right side. Albie scoops it up. And the throw to first is in time. One gun. Here's Randall Gritchett. He's 0-1 thus far.
Right fielder number 15, Randall Gritchett.
Here, you just hold it, baby.
And here's a fastball. Ball for strike one.
Good pitch right there from the reliever. Tough for hitters to do much with pitches in that location unless they're looking for it.
1-1 the count now. The 1-2. Misses. Ball
yep,
two.
That ball went out.
There it is.
In there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now.
That was a big strike out there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to, and that second out was really important at this point in the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
One ball, no strikes to count. One run, five hits, and no errors for the Red Sox to this point.
2-0.
And the changeup is way low that time. Grounded is short.
Well, so you better get that, man. Come on.
Red Sox go down 1-2-3. Score remains tied 1-1. Standing in, Tony Kemp. He'll see what he can do leading off the home eight.
Second baseman, Tony
Kemp. Hey, have a rip. Take a can. Here you go.
Hey, nobody out now. Nobody out.
Hey, see it. Drive it. Let's go, big dog.
Come on. Get ahead. Stay ahead. Let's go, kid. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, renting a suite for a game at Fenway Park is an ideal way to enjoy the live action in the privacy and comfort of your own living room. Fenway suites are perfect for corporate gatherings.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike.
Hey, let it rip, let it rip.
The wind up and the 0-1.
1-1-1.
This will get foul for 2-2. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2.
Oh, come on.
That one stayed too low, apparently.
Well, that's a great take there, right there, that slider down and in. That's one of the toughest pitches to lay off of as a hitter. That hard breaking ball coming down and in at the back foot. A tough take on a good pitch.
Almora is right there, one down. The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands
now
in.
Batting.
He's one for two in this
fielder, one. Andrew Benintendi.
First pitch on its way.
Counts 1-0.
Here as we'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. One run, five hits, and no errors for the Red Sox.
The hell? Come on.
Two balls and no strikes now to the Red Sox left fielder.
D-Rock.
The circle changed 2-0, but he can't make contact. 2-1.
Boy, what a time to pull the string on him. On 2-0. There's no way anyone's thinking changeup, so if you can locate it, that's pretty much unhittable.
Hey, here we go.
Hey, find something you like up there.
One down, one down.
Hey, come on now, one time, right here. Need you right here, kid.
Come on, big guy. You drive it right here.
Huh, that's weird.
That's up. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Right side, hit hard. Dive, but he can't get it. It's through into the outfield. Here's J.D. Martinez. He was a double play victim last time around.
Designated hitter.
From the stretch. And that's missed outside.
Wow, foul count now 1-0 with a real good slugger up at the plate. This is the time as a pitcher you have to really make some good pitches. This is not the time to just groove one right down the middle.
Line towards center field. Almora is there now, and he has it, two gone.
That's one of those tough luck outs that'll drive you crazy as a hitter. He drove that fastball, but couldn't get it down, so he has to take hard contact as a consolation.
Now batting, center fielder, Williams.
And no one better. What's up right here?
Up next will be Nick Williams. And he puts it on the ground to
shoot. Good.
On the first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. One left for the Red Sox. Still tied one apiece. Rafael Devers, the next to bat. He'll lead things off against the same reliever that finished off the last inning.
Well, you don't see in this day too many relievers going multiple innings, but guys have to earn that trust from their managers. We'll see how he handles it here.
Okay, you need to hold it here.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Nope.
And here's one that misses for the leadoff man in the inning. The number six hitter in the lineup. It's ball one.
Hey, come on, baby. See it.
Hey, come on now. Let's go.
There it is.
He fires in a strike this time. One ball and one strike.
Come on, big guy.
Off the slider, 2-1 home, taking the strike two.
All right, one time here.
Come on now,
2-2 one more time. Fouled away.
Hey, get your pitch right up there, huh? Let's go, kid.
Two, two, one more time. Soft liner toward short. And a not pulling this time. He's 2-for-4 for the game. So it's a leadoff base hit to start the Red Sox after the inning.
Hey, that's a nice piece of hitting right there to put the winning run on base. Interesting here, this is where you play a little bit of manager. It's an AL game. Let's see if he enjoys a little National League style. I want to move the runner up right here. American League, it's nasty.
He's out.
Throw's going to go on to first, so a perfect sacrifice there is now the
all right.
Run moves into scoring position here. There's the first baseman now, Mitch Moreland. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game. This time, none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
Yeah, big moment. We need you. Here we go. Watch out for us. Get a strike out. Come on, big dog. We need it.
Skied in the air to a straightaway
halfway,
left.
Halfway.
Tomas is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now. Stepping in, Randall Bridger, and he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. Question is whether they'll even pitch to him. Here's the first pitch. This is ball one. Possibly winning runs at second with two down, however. Strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's
count
one and
one
two now.
And two.
Here we go. Make some.
There we go.
Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means we'll have to go a little longer tonight to find a winner. 10th inning coming up, all tied at 1-1. Alex Plumlee takes the ball, looking to make sure this game.
Hey, it took them an extra frame to do it, but hey, they're not going to complain as they lock up a nice road victory here in 10 innings.
4-2, the final score tonight. Atlanta earned the victory despite only collecting 4 total hits. Number 11 earns the victory out of the bullpen, his 5th. Alex Claudio records the save, his 24th on the season. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. From my partners Dan Plesac and Mark DeRosa, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a special presentation of MLB The Show. For more, follow us. Number 11 enters from the bullpen to do the pitching.
Number 11.
Oh. Now I'm trying to see if I can catch the Bears press conference, but for some reason on my phone it says it's going on, but on the app. But I don't see it. Oh, so it's kind of weird. Heck, let's do it later.
Stepping in now, the speedy Tony Hint. Went deep earlier, and he's 2-for-4 to this point.
That was a good pitch.
As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, your final thoughts on
Freeman, the tall body out there.
Competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage. Yeah, you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location. It was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point. Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this.
Yeah, I think tomorrow we're going to end up playing some of our Bears franchise and cutting through that.
Wind up, here comes the 0-2 pitch. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that'll wind up a foul ball just to the right of Pesky's pole. Lined into right, a base hit.
I might also want to pump up some, like, Watch Dogs or something like that to, finish that game. We also have some battle tech we might want to come up on tomorrow. For the weekend, so we can get some good solid hours out of that and finish that game.
Success against some of the better hitters in the game. You got to get that pitch right there. 0-2, he's almost certainly out. 1-1, he's got a chance to really do some damage.
It wasn't at all where I wanted that slider. That wasn't either, but got away with it.
Moving under it, Altair.
Mine.
And that's the second out of the inning. Rafael Devers, the next to bat. Nine so far, 2-for-4, but the hits are a home run and a double. aggressive with the first pitch. Here it comes. Makes a look down at the knees for a strike. Williams leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning.
Wow, what a lucky hit.
Catch all of that baseball, placing it for a double in the outfield. That's a great piece of hitting.
Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. Hit hard down the line. This will wind up a foul ball, strike two.
Hey, two here. Need you right now. Make something happen for us.
Fastball straightens him up a bit. 1-2 now.
0-2 pitch, not even close to the zone, and a fastball might be an indication that he's going to start using some of his secondary pitches.
Dude, none of those sliders were even close to where I wanted them.
Into the monster seat.
Fuck out of here, man. Come on.
Eduardo Escobar standing in.
And that's the thing. If I was a starting pitcher, I would be up in the freaking 90s. And, stats right now. You better catch that. I don't want to be out anymore. I wouldn't be 82 because I wouldn't be pitching every day but one inning. See two batters, three batters. Gotta be seeing six innings of batters. Coming in bullshit games.